Hi, I'm Eric Alita with the Google Developer Relations team. This screencast will show you how to get started with the AdWords API PHP client library. The library requires PHP version 5.2 and the extensions SOAP Client, OpenSSL, and curl. The first thing we need to do is download the library. The best way to find it is by going to the AdWords API documentation at code.google.com/APIs/AdWords. From here, click on Docs, Libraries and Samples, and PHP Client Library. This is the main project page of the AdWords API PHP Client Library. On the right-hand side of the page is a convenient link to download the latest version. Once the download is complete, extract it to a folder of your choice. Before you can start using the library, you must set the authentication information. Browse to Source, Google, API, Ads, AdWords, and open the file auth.ini. When testing a new library, it's best to use a sandbox account. More information on the sandbox environment is available in the screencast Intro to the AdWords API Sandbox. Entering your sandbox credentials, starting with the email and password of your Google account. Enter a user agent that identifies your application. The application token itself is ignored in the sandbox. And enter a developer token, which is your email address plus the currency code. Finally, set the client ID to the email of one of the automatically generated client accounts and save the changes to the file. Since we are using the sandbox environment, we must also set the default server in settings.ini. For the sandbox, this is adwords-sandbox.google.com. You are now ready to make requests with the library. The examples folder contains a subfolder for every version of the API that the client library supports. To start, we'll open a command prompt and browse to the examples folder. The first example we'll run is getAllCampaigns.php. Since this is a new sandbox account, there will not be any existing campaigns. To create some campaigns, we'll run addCampaign.php. This example added a new campaign to the account. And if we rerun getAllCampaigns.php, we can see it returned to the results. Now let's create a new example to pause a campaign. Create a new file called pausecampaign.php and open in the text editor. The first thing we need to do is include the AdWords PHP library. One way to do this is to set the include path to contain the source code for the PHP client library and then require the AdWords user class. You don't need to require each service individually, as they will be automatically required by the AdWords user. Next, we'll paste in a try-catch loop to ensure that any errors generated by the library will be caught and displayed. Next, we'll create the AdWords user object, which will load the credentials from the auth.ini file set earlier, and then enable logging. The campaign service can be retrieved from the AdWords user using the getCampaignService method. We'll need to set the campaign ID for the campaign we wish to modify. If we go back to the command prompt, we can pull the ID from the previous example. Next, we'll create the updated campaign object, setting the ID to the ID of the existing campaign, and changing the status to paused. Now that we've created the update campaign object, we can create the operation that will perform the change. We'll set the operand to the campaign we just created, and the operator to set, which will perform an update. Finally, we'll create an array of operations containing only this one operation. We're now ready to make the API call, which is done by calling the campaign service method mutate, passing in the array of operations. Finally, we'll loop over the results, displaying the name, ID, and status of each of the campaigns that were changed. We'll save this example, go back to our command prompt, and run the example. Now we can see that our campaign was updated and has the status paused. Updates to the library will be announced on the project's homepage. The AdWords API blog will contain information about new services being launched. If you have any questions about using the API, you can post them to the forum. Finally, if you find any bugs in the PHP client library, create an issue on the issue tracker. Thank you for your time, and enjoy using the client library.